Just outside of Cape Town, South Africa, an ambitious restoration project is underway. Through the Greater Cape Town Water Fund, the Nature Conservancy is supporting the removal of water-thirsty invasive plants that are contributing to the area's water shortages. Between 2014 and 2018, the Cape experienced its worst drought on record. Dam levels dropped below 15%, and the city narrowly avoided running out of water. Removing the invasives will also reclaim habitat for the rare native plant species. But what about the life beneath the surface of the Cape's rivers?
My master's thesis and now my PhD subsequently is looking at climate change effects specifically on the giant redfin and freshwater fishes in the Cape Fold ecoregion. A redfin is a little minnow. During the mating season, which is usually around September, the males put on a fantastic mating display and their fins usually go bright, bright red. The giant redfin is the biggest redfin species that we have, and there are only 3 known populations of this species, which really tells us how threatened it is.
Scientific data collected thus far show that removing invasive plants improves the quality and quantity of water flowing through these rivers. These benefits ensure that endangered fish, like the redfin, have the conditions they need to thrive.
I think what's really important to stress, not only as a scientist but as a human being, is that we need to balance the needs of all living things. Redfins require really good water quality, and so do people. So if the redfins are thriving and happy, then the people will be too.